Hey all, welcome to week four of my course. Hopefully you enjoyed week three, which was about tenants subscription creation. So this week we are going to create a DevOps organization. We're going to work with Visual Studio Code, work with repositories, and we're going to sync up the files of Kafka Terraform module onto our DevOps repository. So let's get started. First of all, what we need to do is we need to just open up an in private window. I'm just going to type in dev.azure.com. That's going to redirect me. Now I'm just going to click cell free. And now I will just sign in with my account. So I've entered the password. Now I'm signing in. And what you're going to have is you'll get this page. You may get a page which is going to be this. We'll need a few more details, so just click continue and you will have that. I've used this before, so that's why it hasn't asked me. So I will select Kafka Terraform as a project name, although that's going to be what my organization is, an organization and project I'll cover in a second. Project visibility, you want to set it as private, and you will now need to enter the capture. Right, now it's going to log into the Azure DevOps organization. It takes a little bit. Okay, now that it has logged in, what we will see now is if I go into Azure DevOps over here at the top, what's going to happen is it's created me a new organization. And it's created me Andre 072712. But if I wanted a new organization, I would click on new organization. I would actually find, for example, Kafka Terraform. I believe this one's taken, but it has to be globally unique. So if I open up here and I click continue, turns out Kafka Terraform wasn't taken. So it's actually now created me a Kafka Terraform organization, as you can see. Now, the Kafka Terraform organization is globally unique. And what an organization essentially is a top level of DevOps. And in that organization, you will have then multiple projects underneath that organization. So your organization is the highest level, and that organization could depend on that tenant. So for example, if I work on many different clients, I may have to switch my tenant directory, and therefore I might get access to different organizations because they are going to be placed in different tenants. So in this case, I have Kafka Terraform placed under this tenant. So projects are just underneath the organization in hierarchy. So I'm just going to call it again the same thing, Kafka Terraform. And as you can see, I've got private and public. So I'm just going to create a private project. So this is a project, but let me just go through quickly on what your organization might be. So your organization might have different settings. So your organization will have, example, view billing, view usage, view your projects. So for example, right now, I just have the Kafka Terraform projects underneath, so I can have many different projects. I can have users, I can set my permissions over here, I can set the policies. So if I wanted to, restrict access to repositories or something on a global level, then I would do that over here. And this will apply to all my projects. While projects are more like specific, and we're gonna cover that as we go along. So there is a recommendation sometimes to just make sure your projects could be aligned to maybe your business unit. So if you are coming from a certain background, then maybe the project should be to that business unit, while your organization as a whole should be managed from the top level. So that's your organization. There's many settings over here. I'm not going to dive deep too much into it, but if you're interested, check out the settings, have a play around with it, and I will leave some articles as well so you can have a look at those, that documentation. So from this, we're going to look at the projects now. So in the projects, there's a couple of different areas that you have. So you have an overview, you have your wiki, so you can create like a wiki article, and it's going to, you can create like documentation as code, basically. So you use Git to create your documentation, and you know, you can actually do it that way. The wiki is really great because it keeps things in one place with that particular project. There are boards. Now, I personally love boards because I believe they're much better than Jira. Now, Jira is like for, you know, if you were going to work with Agile DevOps and create projects and new work items and user stories, that is kind of element is there. And I've worked with both of them and I really love boards. I'm not going to cover boards as part of this course, but if you're interested, let me know and I will definitely release a video fully on boards. So the two we're going to work on is repos and pipelines. Test plans are if you were working, like for example, on an application and you wanted all users to test, you would get them to install like a plugin. And for, and then you can get the users to use that. And artifacts is basically you package up your application to be used in, like for example, release pipelines. But we're not going to cover test plans or artifacts right now because we are just going to cover repos and pipelines just to get started. Okay, so for this video, we're going to work with repos. Okay, and with repos, we are going to need a couple of things. We're going to need to, first of all, I'm going to initialize this repository. So it's going to be, I have a repository here. Now, this is how I navigate my repositories. I click on the top, and this is where you might have a new repository, managed repository. And basically what a repository is where your files sit, but we'll work with Git. So essentially what Git does, Git looks at your version control. So for example, if you make any changes to those files, Git records that, and Git then tracks any changes. So it's a really useful way to keep on top of your infrastructure as code. So we're going to just work with the Kafka Terraform. We could create new repositories, but we're not going to do that just as an introductory. But this is going to be like Kafka Terraform. But what I'm going to also quickly do is I'm going to just give it a quick rename. I'm only doing this before I get everything going. So I'm going to just call it Kafka Terraform Modules, and I'm going to rename it. Now in here, so if I go into my Kafka Terraform again, repos, so I can now see that I've got Kafka Terraform Modules. So essentially what we're going to do now is we are gonna install two elements. We're gonna install Visual Studio Code and Git. So first of all, we will search for Visual Studio Code. We'll find it. Click on download Visual Studio Code. I'll include the link for you guys to download Visual Studio Code if you haven't played about with it already. And this is just basically a next exercise. You go through it, you click next. I like these to add the options so I can right click and open with code. And I will install. So what Visual Studio Code is if you just launch it, Visual Studio Code is that you use it to edit your files. It's kind of like a integrated
development
environment, basically. It's an IDE. So what it does is it allows you to work with your files locally on your machine. It has loads of great features, such as synchronizing and source control, finding, and of course, it stores your files. It's a really great tool. So if you're working with DevOps, it's definitely a must-have tool for you to use. So what we're going to do now is we've installed Visual Studio Code, but we also will need Git. So we will download Git. Now, what you may be thinking of is, why do I need to download Git? So essentially, here's the thing. Git is installed on your local computer, and that helps you track your changes with certain files. It allows you to Git clone, and it allows you to basically manage your files on your local computer. So I will just open up Git. And then I'm just going to do next exercise. If you have any settings that you might usually do when you install Git, let me know. And I could add it into the comments or the description if it is something that is really useful to have. For me, I just personally just use Git as intended and just the next exercise. So we're going to just extract all the files. And there we are. So now I just can finish the setup. I'm going to restart my Visual Studio Code since I've installed Git. Okay, so the next thing what we need to do is we need to actually go to the Kafka from GitHub page. So it's github.com/Azure/Kafka-landing-zones. I will include this link in the description below. So what we need to do is we need to clone the URL. So we're going to copy. So what I usually do is I create on my OS disk, I create a new folder called projects, because it is a lot easier to then navigate if you just do it on your local disk C. Otherwise, you might have to go into all your user profile and document settings, and it's a little bit iffy to navigate. So what I usually do now, I'll show you guys what I mean with this in a bit. But essentially, what I need to do now is I need to CD into my actual projects folder. So right now, by using CD and using two dots, I'm going back to my local disk C. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to CD to my projects folder, which I created. Use tab to autocomplete. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to write Git. I'm going to write clone. I'm going to copy and paste this. You can use shift insert, which I find much better as a key command rather than control V. Now, what I've done here is I've actually cloned what was on GitHub into the projects for Kafka Terraform Landing Zones. So over here, I will have all my code. So what I'm going to also do is I click on view and I click on hidden items. So just so I can display the hidden items. And I'm going to just sort by name and I'm going to see Git. Now, .git and .github, I'm just going to delete that because I don't really need that anymore. But I do want everything else. So I'm going to use this and copy that. But what we also need to do is we also need to initialize our repository, which we have had. Sorry, clone the repository that we've created over here. So we're going to clone our repository. And then we're going to click into Visual Studio and I'm going to do again git clone. And notice now I'm cloning my repository. It's going to ask me to sign in. So I'm just going to use my Microsoft account to sign in. Right at Kafterv. And now I've signed in and it has actually cloned my repository in Azure DevOps. So as you can see, I've cloned Kafterv from module and this is with my Git. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy all of this and I'm going to paste it into here. And we're going to replace the readme.md as well. So now all my files I have copied and pasted off in from which the Kafterv from landing zones, which I downloaded and got the files from, and I've copied it and pasted into my project, which is being synced up with my repo. Okay, so well, if I look at Visual Studio Code now, and I'm going to open folder. Projects and then Kafterv from modules. So I have now opened that folder and notice now that you have a lot of green colors and a yellow as well, which is a modified version, and green indicates it's currently on track. So I need to commit it to get it tracked. So in a way, what I need to do now is if you look at your source control on Visual Studio Code at the left, this is what helps you navigate your repositories. And you can actually write a message. So I'm going to write initial commit for my repository. I'm going to click on tick. And this is going to commit my stages to my local computer. I'm going to click yes. Now this is working fine, so I can now click on sync changes. I might get an error now. It hasn't, because the reason it hasn't given me an error is because I've already used this computer a little bit before. But essentially what you might need to do is if you get an error saying it can't sync up, you might need to enter these two commands into your Visual Studio Code terminal. So just if you run these commands, this sets your global username for Git, and this also sets your user.email. So I'm currently using the Kafterv from 2.0.microsoft.com, but if you have a GitHub account, you can also use that. So now what we will see is we will see if I refresh this page, we now have all the Kafterv for modules in one place. And hopefully you have enjoyed this video. I know this was a bit fast paced, and especially if you're beginning, it might take you a few attempts. Message me on Discord. I can definitely help you out with any problems that you may be stuck on. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, if you found this content useful, follow me on LinkedIn. Subscribe and like and hit that bell on YouTube. And I'm looking forward to the next one. We're going to cover Rover. So looking forward to seeing you there. Till next time.